Samael Singh.
Yeah, but he's a player, though. Everybody caters to the players.
Yes. Yes, they do. Most definitely they do. You're 100% right, Ryu. You should become a player again. 5 seconds remaining. All right. So, everyone, actually, make sure your audio is turned off in game just in case there's anything randomly transmitted. Just so we make sure our Dota TV audience... Yep, no, don't turn that on. Don't turn that on. Let's leave everything exactly as it is. You're good. All right. So, welcome to everyone who's tuning in inside of Dota TV. We are... Well, we're here. We'll probably be here every single time until we get kicked out for the other English casters who are here for the games. But we are here to do Power Rangers versus Team Secret, the first game of the European group stage. A very simple bracket, the way they do it. An entire group stage. Everyone plays one game against each other. So full round robin.
And we didn't even get to talk about that.
No, we didn't. We were going to talk about that, but we forgot about it. That's why I'm bringing it up now during the drafting phase. So we can only spend a couple of minutes talking about it.
Right.
So yeah, number one out of the group stage goes directly to TI.
I love that.
So you can qualify for TI by only playing best of ones. Swindles was very happy.
Oh yeah. That is.
He's just like, I'm glad I got a Meepo and a Ricky and a Techies player on my team. I was like, wow, this could really go well.
And yeah, Huskar, man. People have been using Huskar recently again too. That's the thing.
Yeah, you don't want to get Huskar. And Power Rangers is a team that will quite willingly Huskar you.
Oh, that dazzle though. I'm gonna laugh when it shows up.
It's leaving up the sleep, but it's to stop Team Secret from having this immortal lineup.
Yep.
Team Secret, they had to play through the open qualifiers, obviously, as the roster changes happened, and we now have Bulba.
Bulba.
In Team Secret. After Universe basically just said, fuck this, I'm out.
When I was watching Universe play, it looked like he didn't even want to be there. I think it felt like after the first 2 weeks or something, it was just like him doing his own thing and everybody wasn't gelling at all. Maybe with Bulba, they'll talk a lot more or something and they'll be a team.
I remember there was a conversation about this, primarily at the...
Manila?
No, it was before Manila. It was at Epicenter.
Epicenter?
When all the teams, like, you had both EG as well as Team Secret there, and both of them failed. And the big question was going to be, how well, like, are these teams going to do at Manila? And most people were saying both teams have a very similar problem. They just can't synergize. They don't work well together. It could be a clash of personalities. It could be a clash of just, like, visions about how they should be playing as a team. It could just be basic play styles. A lot of things were going wrong. And most people were saying that Team Secret should be able to pull through because of the strength of Puppy. Puppy obviously being a top 8 finisher in every single TI.
It's so hard to bet against Secret.
It's,
you know,
it's not even hard to bet against Secret. Like, there's a lot of things in Team Secret, I think, which you're like, man, like, things can go so horribly wrong. Arteezy can never win. Eternal Envy can always help him to never win. Yeah. Bulba, like, he's always been that kind of underrated offlaner, even though he's got a lot of praise from... most of the people inside the scene.
I think, as most people say, you need at least like one clown on your team. Or I think it does help out the scene. Like, you need a sexy Bambo. You need at least a Bambo, and I think Bulba brings that because.
Really, you put Bulba as the clown? That's Pylai Dai, bro.
Pylai Dai can be a clown, but Bulba, I think, takes the cake.
Okay.
I feel like Pylai Dai is sometimes really quiet at times too.
Uh huh. He can be. He can be. At the same time, I remember when he was playing for Cloud9 and they were boot camping at the office. And, like, Eternal Envy asked us not to come around because they were saying such harsh things. They were worried the people would...
like, you effing idiot. Everybody sucks.
Yeah,
like,
pretty
I'm
much.
Pretty
like,
sure
they
blame each
that
other.
That was when Sing Sing was playing for them, too. Yeah. And they were just going ham at each other. It's like, just... This doesn't reflect us. So don't look at us in this way. We're a very different type of group. This is just the way we communicate.
Cloud9, the only way they win is by... trash talking themselves up. That's how they win.
That was how you get second at every event, which you shouldn't be. You shouldn't snuff that.
Second
still
place
good.
Is really nice.
However, until the teams like Team Liquid right now, who are very comfortably directly invited, don't have to go through this.
No.
That's where the power of friendship helps you survive. Okay, let's talk about a draft because we're a fair way through. I don't think there was anything really interesting, which is why I was happy to have the side conversation. It's a Dazzle Earth Spirit opener, Timber L, the Titan, Secret. This is absolutely nothing different to what they did in the open qualifier. Puppy was always prioritizing the Elder Titan in the first phase. So no surprise there.
They run Ricky so much, too. And so I think Ricky's one of those strong picks. I'm really surprised, though, that Slardar got through for either side. And it went to second stage banning because I think Slardar is just a huge, like, this hero caused so many problems.
I can understand the first phase, and the whole thing at, like, Manila we were talking about is, like, Slardar Diacite is great.
Slardar Diacite.
But Slardar Radiant Side is shite.
It's Slardar, you kind of have to overwhelm the team then when it's on Radiant, where you just take all their towers, take all the team fights. But it's definitely easier on the Dire side because of the Roche.
Yeah. But to prioritize the Earth Spirit as well as the Dazzle almost feels like you're also blocking Team Secret in a way, who then just pick up another core. I say another core, their first core in the phase.
When you do Dazzle Earth Spirit like that, though, it's showing you that you want to play defensive, and it also can open up the enemy team to pick Enigma. But Team Secret, like, they're not going to play greedy this game because they already have Witch Doctor ET. So at least that's one good thing. Power Rangers get information on that. I'm really not a fan of Queen of Pains and Pucks anymore in this meta, but...
You need burst damage against the Timbersaw.
Yeah, burst damage is always nice to have against the Timbersaw.
You need something, and she can also build into Orchid if her lane goes well. This might deter her as well, Team Secret, from running the Timber mid against the comp. She does not even...
It doesn't really matter too much. As long as Timber gets level 3, it's kind of like the Dragonite effect. You get Dragonite level 3, you get that level 2.
The upside is you won't have an escape mechanism because the mid Timbers never level up chain early on. So Earth Spirit rotation may, in fact, be very useful.
This is a really good pick for Team Secret now, though.
They're so tanky.
They have a really good team fight. They have good disengage. They have good sustain. Their lineup is just well-rounded, whereas Power Rangers, they kind of have to kite in the team fights right now. And then they have to heavily rely on the Queen of Pain to get a good ulti to win these team fights.
They will have success, though, when the Beastmaster is able to pick up his Necrobook and Blink Dagger, because then the Timbersaw's got some things to worry about. And also, I apologize, my nose is about to go completely ham. I don't know when it's going to happen.
He's crying already, guys.
No, I'm not crying, but you're definitely going to, like, lose your eardrums when it happens.
I do.
I sneezed when we were out in the panel room before. I'm just like, holy crap, we're there. Like,
your brain's...
It just bounced. The sound. It was like, whoa, okay.
Earthquake.
Earthquake. Be like standing in the middle of it, like the Grand Canyon and just screaming and you hear the bounce coming back. That's my American reference for you. I've never actually been to the Grand Canyon.
I drove over it to come to Cali.
Is there a road going over the canyon?
Actually, Matt drove. I think a train. Train.
A train goes over the Grand Canyon?
I think it does. I came over here. I had to come over some kind of huge canyon. It might have not been the Grand Canyon. That was like 6 or 7 years ago when I came to visit. But it was huge. And I think it was. So I'm pretty sure they do have trains over it.
You think if it goes long enough, you would require a bridge. But at the same time, making a bridge of a place which is falling down, maybe not the greatest idea.
It's not the best. It's okay. Twitch chat knows everything. No. They'll find something.
Check the foundations. Okay, Puppy. Easy. Eternal Envy gets himself an aggressive hero. They want some physical damage. Power Rangers do still have a lot of control, which could go against the Weaver, but it's not guaranteed. Like, the Roar has to do a lot of work. If Envy can get to the Lincoln Sphere, then Power Rangers actually have some more troubles with the Dazzle and the Earth Spirit locking down the Weaver.
You kind of want to have a strength hero here, too, against the ET. Like, Morphling is so crap against ET, even though it could be a good hero here to, like, split up the map and farm freely. But when you go into the team fights with the ET, that natural order is just going to kill Morphling. All that morph strength, or to strength to agility, it's just gone. But I think Power Rangers do need, like, a heavy split pusher, because I don't think they're going to win team fights, or they could just go all-out team fight here. With a good core, and maybe like Sven? Slark.
I had him in the back of my mind. I should have spoke Slark up so I could sound really smart.
No,
but I was looking at all the other ones that were still remaining, and there wasn't that much to offer. Like, you're talking about split push heroes. Like, the Naga was taken out, the Ember was taken out, Power Rangers didn't really have a lot of choices. So, with a lineup like this, This at least helps them with the early aggression that can come from the Slark. It's a nice controller against the supports. It's a hero which can probably break free of that Elder Titan stomp because you see it coming from a mile away. So Goddam's Dark Pact can be really, really useful in this game.
The biggest problem, though, is Temersal. Like, Temersal just eats this hero for breakfast. And so you're picking it into that. So you're going to have good silence as an Earth Spirit or a good time with Queen of Pain getting fast Orchid. So Power Rangers, they're on like a good timing window here. Where they get their Shadow Blades, they get their, you know, Necro Books, and they have to kill constantly Team Secret around the map. Because Team Secret, I feel like going into the later stages of the game, they're just going to have so much survivability from all these heroes, and their team fight is going to be very scary.
Wait, what? All right, we're going to predict stuff.
Ooh.
First player to get 50 last hits. Wow!
All right.
That's a no-frickin' brainer. Total number of deaths at game end. I think this is actually going to be pretty brutal, so I'm actually going to say 41 to 55. It's not the maximum amount. Time of the destruction of barracks from Team Secret. With this lineup, you're looking at... I actually think it's...
It's pretty clash heavy.
For the first barracks, though...
I think it's 41 to 55.
You're going to 41 to 55?
I think this is going to be... It's either going to be 35 or 45, I feel.
Okay, I'm going to go 30 to 40. I'm going to go 30 to 40.
I'm going to go 40 plus.
And then help you with the last one. Total number of player deaths by 25. PL's going to take time before they start fighting, and Team Secret are also going to do the same kind of thing, unless someone goes completely over-aggressive. So number 4, I'm actually going to say it's only going to be 0 to 15.
Yeah, this is a really tougher one.
I'm going to say 0 to 15 in the first phase.
It's just how well they want to disengage and stuff. Yeah, I think it's 0 to 15. I agree.
Okay.
I think it's going to be like 14 or something.
Okay, and that is going to be our tips to help you as the betting will now close.
How do I close it? Help, Toby, help!
It's the little freaking button.
I wanted to have the
A-OK. With the stolen shield. That's the defense. That's our logo!
Oh, someone salty.
They took our logo! It's the defense
logo if the Dota 2 logo is...
It's the defense shield!
It's Dota 2.
I'm just saying. Wait,
the shield in Dota 2.
Can I not get rid of this? Like
exactly. That's what I was saying. That's why I wanted the OK button, Toby. Like,
yeah.
I wanted to have like OK, get this out of my way. It's like the predictions.
Volvo, please. please.
Tilted already in
please
first
remove?
First stream of the.
Please remove. Okay.
Oh, one creep though by ES. He won the game. That was probably a D word. Yep, there's D word here in the middle.
Because we were obviously paying attention.
I was
to
paying attention. Yeah, because
hey,
see,
you're
this,
the code caster. You're meant
sentry.
To do that kind of jazz.
It's a sentry ward. I got you.
This top lane, Big Num looks like he's trying to try and punish Bulba. If he times this right as well, Bulba forward. They focus on the Tide Hunter. He's that tankiest of them all. With the leash to lock him in, but J4's losing too much life. Puppy, he's hitting like a truck. But who's gonna go down first? There it is, Puppy up on the top, and you got the Tide Hunter. Who's salving up? First blood goes the way of Team Secret. What the hell is that prediction thing that also popped out that time?
The progress for... Man, I'm doing extra work
what?
Here. Progress
That's
for
pop
the
out every
the death.
Single time.
Yeah, I know. It's like the progress for the death and everything. That's just kind of weird. J4, Poison Touch is nice early on, but when you have these three heroes like this,
oh,
and you're
Puppy's
baiting,
in trouble.
Oh.
Ball to forward, but Puppy, even with slowed up by the Poison Touch, is able to sidestep it, and now the body block from Big Num, he's able to get the last attack in. Bulba as well, Big Num can't get in front of him. And Bulba will just have to walk away.
Yeah, I'm going to lose my prediction now with the Slark having most last hits because this aggressive dual lane.
Wait, you chose Slark to have the last hits?
Yeah, because the way is he can go into the jungle, and Dark Pack this if they stack this, but
okay.
That and so that's why I feel he would beat the Weaver. But
it's rather difficult to move off the lane though when you get a Tide Hunter and Elder Titan like bearing down. Supports can't just stand there.
Yeah, I thought
so you
kind of
slip
into the jungle.
Off. Your gamble you could have gone for was actually Cheshire Cat.
Yeah. You might have it too because the jungle creeps.
At the same time, it's EE safe lane uncontested. Alright, if he doesn't have more CS than any of the Power Rangers heroes, then something is wrong. Because Puppy does this, moving into the dire jungle, looking to assault, and he may even kill off Cheshire Cat if he only knew, and he doesn't. Instead, he's using the stomp. You know, he also doesn't spirit. This is something that Syndrome was telling me about. The fact that when you use that level 1 stomp before you have Astral Spirit, you get both the physical as well as the magical damage on one spot.
So
because it actually counts the fact like that the spirit is inside of you.
Oh, that's
so
really cool.
So it doubles it up. That's
a lot of mana, though.
We don't know if it's a bug, though. It could be a bug. It may not be a bug.
180. It's pretty hefty. He's lucky he got that first blood, though, for ET there. Mm-hmm. So he has Tranquils now. Freely roaming around the map with max movement speed, it feels like. Especially when you get that Astral on somebody. This is going to be a hard-hitting ET roaming around. So right now, like you said, EE is just free farming. 21 last hits. Hopefully he can start missing some last hits and maybe buy.
I'd like to see what his build's going to be in this game. Because yeah. I was thinking Lincoln Sphere may be a really good choice. But with the inclusion of the Slark, it might be a better idea to go for the BKB Deso. He's already got the Blightstone, which is a value thing. And Bulba. Oh, ET, Spirit, Stomp. Fire space, Bulba, he wants to fight. He's gonna anchor smash available. Now the Paladin Cast's gonna bounce forward. Does it bounce back up to goddamn? No, it doesn't. And the double kick is perfect from Big Num, keeping Bulba away from the front lines. And PR retreat out, but this is now the rotation, making a aggro tri lane versus a defensive tri lane on top lane. But still a completely uncontested Eternal Envy.
Going back a little bit to your build, it's you do want to have the Lincolns eventually for even the Queen of Pain going for the Orchid. So I think Lincoln's best choice this game. And then afterwards Deso and then BKB. I think that is still the best bet.
Alright, goddamn being pushed back out. Just a reminder as well for everyone who is tuning in, the hub is rolling out so many streams.
Too many streams.
Not too many. In a way you can have too much though because you just can't keep up with it all.
I would need we're going to have eventually 8 streams at once.
Yeah, you're getting 2 weeks to actually look at all the replays.
How many eyes do you need for 8 streams? Like 16 you need? I don't even know.
Technically you can probably put one eye per stream if you want to look at it that way.
One eye per stream, that's like, whoa, Toby.
I'm just saying, like, technically you don't have to devote two. Like, it's like, can you keep an eye on him? And they don't say, can you keep both eyes on him? Unless you're like, he's a real problematic child.
You're gonna be stuck being called crazy eyes here.
Wow. Okay. This top lane, like, I don't know what Power Rangers is meant to do against it. They don't have any level of aggression. Big Num is not that high up in levels. J4 is kind of like... he didn't even level up Shadow Grave because he went for the Poison Touch as well as the Shadow Wave. So they wanted to get the jump on to the Leash, to the burst damage with the Dazzle. Obviously, with the Earth Spirit rolling in, you'd have a lot of burst physical damage coming out from that Shadow Wave. But it's just not the case here. And I also want to keep my secondary eye over on Arteezy. So the top lane is looking to brew up something. But Arteezy has 1 point up in Timberchain. And up against Arise, Arise has been known to put himself in a very risky position. But it's normally to try and bait out some kind of like overextension from the opposite mid. So I'm keeping a close eye on him. Whoops.
This could be a good kill. Could be a double kill potentially.
Oh, Sentry. It drops. Arise. The Stomp is off target. Arise moves up. He thought with the Invis rune it would be a very easy grab at the top rune, but he still walks away with no deaths.
Even if they got the stomp off, it would have been just harassment onto the Queen of Pain, which is what you want to do. It helps free up the farm for Arteezy in the mid lane. And as we talked about, the reactive armor level 2, it's just so easy for Demmer to stay in the mid lane. So he's got a lot of CS, even beating out the Queen of Pain so heavily. That's pretty interesting.
Well, why is Arteezy even scared? Like, he's walking around with the raindrops. Like, you look for your burst damage from Queen of Pain. That's what normally makes Queen of Pain Queen of Pain, right?
All of the bursts from Power Rangers is magic. Like, yeah. All of it. So yeah. That's why you want the raindrops.
But they wanted that up against the Timber, but you're blocking 120 magical. And the Scream, like, is at 140 damage at the moment for Arise. So it's good luck. Hey, yeah! Woo!
We lost.
I won, man. I won.
I lost.
Correct on the first one. It is, in fact, Eternal Envy who wins the first phase. First player to get 50 last hits. Let's see how I go
how much,
with the rest
how
of
How much
them.
Do you get for that? Wait, what?
I have no idea. Self-respect. Top lane, Bulba being initiated on. Rather difficult when he's a 0-2-2, but he doesn't have a South Shield, but the Paralyzing Cast is definitely going to help out Bulba. Damn, that Shadow Dance. I mean, that freaking Dark Pack doing a lot of damage. Sonic Wave committed by Arise, finds the kill. The kick follows through into Pile Eye Die. At least gets a silence, but Eternal Envy rotated very early up to this top lane, realizing that all 5 heroes of Power Rangers are there. But Arteezy never arrived. Arteezy is still farming up the mid. He's okay with everything that's going on. I don't even know if Eternal Envy was really that required. But
it's good for Weaver to rotate early on. He's one of those cores that you want early into the team fights because he's built these phase boots, which I'm not going to say it's the best thing when you already have Sakuchi giving you max movement speed, but
it's the E special.
Yeah, you get a lot of additional movement speed plus the damage. And but the weird part about it is he's maxing Swarm right now, at least.
Poppy. Leash going to go on him. Eternal Envy's in the neighborhood, and Goddamn's going to back up. I'm actually not that surprised for EE. Hey, Spoon, good luck, Arise. No blink for 8 seconds. That's a simple timber chain to find the kill.
If he had TP, he would have lived, but sadly, that
big
rotation.
Big Nun knows he's in trouble, too.
Yeah.
If he Chakrams into the right spot, look, okay. He Chakrams up. A Big Nun follows away. Haystrun now going to wear off, but Big Nun with a quick silence. I'll leave it at that. But yeah, it was actually one of the things that you always used to praise RTZ for, because it was back in the era, I'm talking like maybe a year and a half ago now, where the safe laners were very, very passive. Like, it was when Black was at his highest peak during Vici gaming time. It's like, you know, we'll just create space and Black will win the game for us, right? And Eternal Envy was one of the very few ones, nice to know about J4, one of the very few players who kind of like took a different approach to it. By picking up the phase boots, he would dive underneath tier 1, almost to tier 2 towers, to attack the offlaner of the enemy. And then he would just time lapse back. So every single time time lapse was off cooldown, he would harass the offlaner, push him completely out of the lane and always back to the well. And sometimes even finding kills. So I always gave huge props to Envy. He was the only person that would love to do the old Facebook build.
I think Facebook is really good, but I would rather see it with Max Geminate. Because that's the problem, right? You need to have that additional attack speed, and then you have an insane amount of burst damage right now because of the phase boots, but you're not getting all those extra attacks you want in with
it does, like, Swarm got buffed, like, multiple patches.
It's really good max level, but with this build, I'm not too sure.
It also lets you dive into the tower because the beetle actually takes hits from the tower.
Yeah, that's
so
good.
So technically,
it also
you
is
also
really
get
good
that.
For Roche too. Like, if you have max swarm and you're tanking it and you're not letting the swarm die,
little puppy.
Oh, I guess
he's gonna break the smoke and thanks to his observe ward on the hillside, he knows exactly when the hell to bail out of here. Should also flag the fact there's a big ancient stack which will go the way of Bulba fairly soon. He's already level 7, but with that extra money, it's going to increase the time of the mech as Eternal Envy. Here you go. Aggressive on J4. He's already had the Geminate attack. J4 going to Shallowgrave himself up. They need to get that bug off him. And Envy, yeah, you know he wants it. You know he wants it, but he can't reach it. And that's where he uses his time lapse. Force a response out. At the same time, Witch Doctor actually dies behind the lines. Arise jumps in for that one and finds the kill.
Nice play there from Arise. His double damage. Securing that kill, but Arise has not had the best time in the last hits department. He's sitting fourth on the net worth. He still has the Sonic Wave to work with. The first one, it was more so like a kill steal that we saw. But we're going to have to see some big ones. I think they're waiting on Earth Spirit to get some levels here. And that's when they're going to try to start going full speed. Yeah, I'm lagging too.
Yeah, we both are.
Oh boy.
We don't drop any frames though, so it looks like the stream is still doing 100% fine.
Just some hiccups.
Yeah, don't know what's going on there. Either way, it might just be... Well, it's not the server, because Team Secret would have probably paused if it was an issue like that.
Are you saying there's an individual that pauses games in their team, Toby?
No idea. T1 tower, now gonna go down. Yep.
Yeah, how do you fight into Ravage is the question. Yeah,
you don't. You don't. You really, really don't. I'm actually more concerned for PR after RTZ gets his next item. And the question mark is that, because you think, like, if he was buying a Yule Scepter, he would have had heart, like, some parts of it, which has been the more prominent build on the Timbersaur of late. Puppy? Arise? Yeah, don't commit for it. You won't find the kill.
Right now, Power Rangers have to think to themselves, okay, so either we get pickoffs around the map, which they're having a really hard time to do, because Beastmaster has been going around, but his smoke ganks have been found out like once or twice now. And now they have to decide, okay, what do we do in team fights? Because they're, so far, Secret of getting the better end of everything. Like, they have full map control right now, and they're just constantly pushing out the waves.
Mm-hmm.
They were hunting EE here, but they're not going to catch him. Also, they have Bulba getting a mechanism already. This is just ridiculous.
That's the flash bomb. Everything's right for him, and PR aren't doing anything to stop it. So
the only way they And like I was about to talk about, with the team fight, that's the biggest problem now, is you have to kill Elder Titan first. If you don't kill Elder Titan first, they're going to turn the team fight every single time.
Yeah. But then if you kill Elder Titan first, then you're probably going to have nothing left to control up the Tidehunter.
Yeah, you're overcommitting. That's the only thing left then is going to be the silence from ES or something.
But then you get forced into this trade-off. Like, Envy's going to take out this bottom tower quite comfortably.
Oh, ET.
Top tower, yep. Puppy going to get roared up. Pilot Eye gets a nice double malediction off. The stomp does go on Goddamn, and in comes out DZ. Wants to slice up Goddamn, who runs down south. Nice Ravage going to come out. Arise, actually dodging it. Thanks to high movement speed of that Hatestrune, they can still look for more. Bulba forward, but Big Num taking heavy damage from Arteezy once again. Bulba with the anchor smash. Big Num still dropping down. The Magnetize doesn't stop Arteezy from finding himself another kill. And J4, Shallow Grave TP out. Unfortunately, Arteezy has a lot of things, but a stun is not one of them, especially when he is rushing the Octarine Core and not going for the more standard kind of build.
I'm playing Bloodstone.
Yeah, it's, oh yeah, sorry, Bloodstone. But most of the time when you, I don't know why I went straight to Octarine. But I've seen most Timber
Souls. That quest, though. There's actually people...
Really?
For the Leshrac quest. It's so annoying. Oh my goodness.
I'm fairly certain that Arteezy is not questing in the middle of TI qualifiers. So yeah, normally it's the point booster into the Yule Scepter, and then you go and finish up your Bloodstone, and then take care of other items on the way.
Yeah, normally... But he's just so farmed right now that he's able to just split it up and get it. And he's gonna have it at a nice time pace here. I don't even see him dying this game, and that's the problem. If you can't kill Timberslaw, he's just going to keep getting these Bloodstone charges because you can't focus him in the team fights.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the problem. And even if you do, you're going to full heal the enemy team. It's like, oh, he killed my Timberslaw. He's going to be back up in like 5 seconds. I full healed my team. We already won the team fight. So this is looking very dire for Power Rangers right now. And they don't have that many options. Like, Gotham, he's went for the Midas. They honestly, Power Rangers are a little bit lost as what to do. They're gonna have to take this game really late if they want to have a chance.
Yeah, they. But you can't even take this game late. You're gonna lose this game if you take it late.
I'm just trying to see their way back into this.
It's gonna be pickoffs. It actually has to be pickoffs. I look more towards the Beastmaster not going level 2 Necrobook and getting that Blink Decker up and running. But he needs gangs like this to succeed. So your Beastmaster, your Blink, your Roar, and then Queen of Pain follows up. Like, Arise, his item progression was also massively delayed, so this Orchid, which they also needed to control up the Timbersaw and get these quick picks, isn't happening, so they don't get the snowball effect the Power Rangers is desiring. That's why we're sitting at 9 kills, but you kind of knew this was going to happen anyway. This is the reason why my prediction was so low for kill counts early on.
Mm-hmm.
Just because, like, Team Secret can easily dodge. They can easily tank.
And it's also Power Rangers have to dodge. If they don't dodge, they're going to lose the team fight.
Here they come, Team Secret. Power Rangers will be forced into the engagement. They don't have everyone with them. J4 is going to break the smoke. Bulba, oh, they try to loop himself around, but J4 can't even get his Shallow Grave off in time. And this is PR's time to bail the hell out of here. TP out as many heroes as possible. Looks like Cheshire Cat won't be so lucky. Is there a stun? There's the ET split up, but Cheshire Cat, he will be lucky enough. The TP completes and the Dazzle is the only one that is lost.
Ravage. No, I'm just kidding.
Not committed. And Goddamn gets the space. Like, he's handed Midas thing, he's now going to finish up his Shadow Blade. Once he reaches the Silver Edge, that's also going to be really useful for the Slark.
That helps out against the Tide, helps out against the Natural Order. There's, and also the reactive armor is probably the biggest thing. They need something to kill the Timbersaw, and the only way is by taking off that reactive armor. So if they can realistically blow Arteezy up with it.
Am I actually gonna be right? Okay, we can't have more than 5 more kills in the next 8 minutes.
If there's one bad team fight though.
Yeah. Then it could easily happen. At the same time, we might just end into an Aegis, like, dodge of fights. Boulder's gonna come forward and be very quick into Shikuchi. The kick is gonna connect. Radiant's bottom tower is under the Observer Ward down for Big Num, so they understand that Envy wants to try and turn and fight this one. There's no tier 1 tower, so there's no easy safety, but Arteezy going the long way up doesn't go the same way as Bulba, which is just directly a PR. But even look at Bulba's build. No Blink Dagger, no 4 stuff. He's going directly into Radiant's the Greaves.
Yeah, it's just to counter out the Earth Spirit. He wants to make sure that he can always have the Roar in team fight, or not the Roar, the Ravage in team fights.
It just destroys your initiation, though. Like, it just means it's a secretly walk at you thing, so PR always know what they're getting into.
Now, that's when they just split the map up as best they can, but the best that they can hope for Power Rangers is trading tier 1s for tier 2s at this stage in the game. Like, that's all they can really do.
Well, they haven't taken a single tier 1 tower yet. In fact, all the tier 1 towers aren't even below 50%. Which is not the dream, but on bottom lane, they need a good kick right now from Big Num. Pileye die. Well, there's the silencer. There won't be a paralyzing cast. Pileye will drop. TZ wants to bail. No major abilities being committed. And again, still, you're buying time. Arise has almost completed up that Orchid. PR are getting to a point where they might be able to actually do something.
Yep. They just need to keep the pace of this game. Keep dodging team fights. Keep getting farm around the map. And then try and find these pickoffs around the map with their heroes. The problem is, when are Seeker gonna finally group up and do something? I think it's gonna happen when they can do it now in the bottom lane, take this tier 2, but I'm trying to see when's the next big objective like Roshan gonna be on their plate. Is it gonna be now after this tower? Or are they gonna defend top? Or are they going to wait for internal Envy's Desolator and then do Rosh?
I wonder if they feel they can actually do Roshan there. Like, it's still up against
I know what you mean. You can always do Rosh if you have max form, 100%. And you tank it, especially if RTZ tanks. And then it'll just get shredded, Roche. But like you mean, the vision, though.
Yeah. It's just like Power Rangers. Do you take the risk and give PR a way back in? Like, if you are dropping down slightly lower, then you might have Arias being able to get a really good timing for his Sonic Wave. Cheshire Cat is getting closer and closer to having some level of initiation. He did actually pick up the second level Necro Book, so they don't have that jump initiation yet, which is still missing heavily from PR. But if they get some vision up, they get a smoke. There's your Hawk. They'll see RTZ. He's going to be the primary target, especially when he pivot chains forward. You're going to get the Sonic Wave off, burn through the mana and the silence. There goes RTZ. Down for 15 seconds, thanks to the fact he's got that Bloodstone up. The Bulba, Ravage over on two. The Storm into the Splitter. Cheshire Cat and Big Num pretty well locked in here, but Wishlock's going to drop as well. Cheshire Cat and Big Num, they're dropping down low. The Paralyzing Cast bouncing between the two of them. They want to bail the hell out of here, but Eternal Envy arrives. Big Num able to boulder himself away. Cheshire Cat can't get the Swarm off him in time. It'll be a double kill going the way of Eternal Envy, and everyone else will bail. And for those people who did their predictions, we're now sitting on 15 kills. 15 kills!
Can we pause the game for 4 minutes, please?
Well, they just count 5 and Eternal Envy searching for 1J4. TP the hell out of there. Save people's predictions here.
Save? Why do I listen to Toby? Why?
Hey, you didn't listen to me for the first one. Arise, a little bit of trouble. He does have Blink, so it's not too much trouble.
If they had Ravage, he was 100% dead.
Yeah.
That is...
It would be a heavy commitment just to kill off the Quap.
I think it's worth it. If you kill off Quap or Slark, solo Ravage is always worth it at this stage of the game. And then you can transition into either Roche or a Tier 2. But it's just good play coming in from Envy, at least getting some rebuttal kills. But that's what they needed to do. Shut down the Timbersaw. He's down to 8 Bloodstone charges. And this is what you have to do against the hero. Slow him down as much as you can.
Spirits out, create a little bit of space. Arise with the Orchid. You kind of like to have a crack. They're going to go for the Orchid over on TZ. Arise doesn't have the ulti. On TZ, is he going to drop fast? Bulbas, still no Ravage. But you do have the Paralyzing Cask and the Death Ward. Cheshire Cat bailing out. Is actually everyone going to live? Predictions, that's going to be fine. We're okay, everyone. We're okay. The Tier 2 tower will be assaulted. The Necrogunners will turn around, try and slow down Team Secret. Remember, they still... they're still good to move forward. Like, how long we got? Like, no one's... Yeah, we still got Roshan available. With Necros down, they might be a little bit more wary about it. Oh, we got 3 minutes. 3 minutes to survive.
Three men dream.
It's for this one. Total number of player deaths by 25 minutes, and we went for 0-15.
Oh, boy. This is cutting it close here.
It's a risky world.
Yep.
We live life on the edge. It's 18. Hit me.
Hit me.
God damn.
What do you mean 18? 20. Please.
Hit on 20. 20. Hit on 20? You're crazy.
I believe in that ace.
That's insanity. That's not even living life on the edge. That's just like cutting yourself right there.
No, that's the most edgy thing you ever do. You're like having a rusty blade shaving your face with.
That's how you tilt Charlie at the table.
It's like, what the... You won?
Yep. That actually would completely, like, flip him out.
Yeah, it's not... It's like, you keep doing it over and over again, and eventually when you do get it, that's just like, I'm done.
Alright, so PR, level 3 Necros are up for Cheshire Cat. I still need to see enough money on him to get that Blink Dagger up and running.
Yep.
The top tower can be taken by Arise, but there's no real reason for Team Secret to fully fight into it. Like, Envy's in a very comfortable spot, thanks to...
Oh, nice. Nice.
Thanks to fate, he's got both the Lincolns as well as the Desolator, so there's not that much fear for Eternal Envy. Bulba now has his Blink Dagger, yep, but he needs mana... Until he's... Okay, yeah, she brought a Clarity out too. So they are looking to fight straight away. Oh, the smoke from PR. Come on, a minute and a half.
Please.
Oh, it is a minute and a half.
No.
Goddamn. He's going to fight Pylite Die. Predictions. Eat my Pylite Die. Okay, goddamn. Silver Edge. He's going to miss his opportunity. Envy's going to rotate over as well. He's going to go inside the Shadow Dead. Envy is going to get silenced. The Sonic Wave will fly out. Envy's going to go down. We'll fail on that one. The Paralyzing Cast bouncing forward. Bulba, he's completely out of mana. He can't Ravage thanks to the power of the Necrobooks. And with Power Rangers moving forward, it's a double kill for Goddamn. You might be sad about the predictions, but you'd be very happy if you're a PR fan as they find a couple more kills.
And we find some lag. But we're back to normal and we are good. Man,
and
Big
Gnome
is carrying this team, though. That's the problem when you don't have Weaver with Manta Style or BKB. One silence from Earth Spirit, max level. That thing lasts forever.
Team Secret are coming over. Puppy does have Splitter. He'll use the Spirit to try and stall things up, but that Sentry Ward reveals the Slark moving forward. Removes a lot of the power of the Elder Titan when he's able to break it with a Silver Edge.
Elder Titan's, like, worse to fight in... to the pit with than like a dark seer, I feel. It's just horrible. The problem is his cooldowns on it is just insane. Like, even if you miss the stomp, even if you miss the astral, I mean it just comes right back up. It's like there always.
Mm-hmm.
So even if you get like a vacuum wall combination, that's dead, it's gone. But then you have ET always in the pit, always in the pit. So what should have been a free Roche isn't just because of this hero.
Well, the Scarab Beetles are gonna miss on the heroes. TP support's coming in. Both BTs as well as ET just TPing in naturally on the tower. And looks like we get to be... Okay, yeah, thank you very much for the 25-minute prediction reminding
thank
us again
you,
that
incorrect.
We're wrong. Thank you, Volvo! Okay, so Power Rangers, I'll still write about EE.
I'm just looking at my other ones. I'm going to look at the other ones and see that...
Oh, yeah, what else are we sitting on? I'm sitting on the first Barracks Destruction at 30 to 40 minutes. And total number of deaths, 41 to 55.
Hmm.
We may not be hitting those. J4, Puppy gonna go for the stomp, able to connect. Bulba's rotating over. It's a good Ravage time, especially with the Ryan's coming in without a BKB. So J4 will drop the kick well off target. The Ravage only connecting on Big Num. This may be enough of an inkling for Power Rangers to initiate in. The attacks fly up. Big Num over towards the tree line, which he was able to destroy as he runs through. A nice kick, but not enough space. Eternal Envy will hit up the hill, grabs himself a double kill, and Orion's getting the hell out of Dodge. Everyone just back to farming. It still shows you Secret's got some bite, but it takes some big abilities to do it.
And this could be a good time for Power Rangers because they just used the Ravage to only kill two supports. And they're going to be up really, really soon here. So they don't have that much time to do Roche.
They're coming down. The Beastmaster Hawk also just timed out from Cheshire Cat. He needs mana.
He's
actually being forced to come down right now. There's no T2 tower for him to TP into. I think this Roshan belongs to Secret. Unless he flew out of Clarity.
They're really scared. They just backed. Oh, they could have just had it, though.
It's also because Cheshire Cat walked past the Observer Ward of Team Secret, so it made it look like he was coming straight down to Roshan. Now, he actually acts as the top lane. Okay, he's already short enough on mana, so Team Secret will be finishing Roshan now.
Beastmaster should top, like you talked about, Cheshire Cat. It's sad to say he didn't even have mana like you were talking about, too. It's just one of those situations where you can't contest, unfortunately. So that's going to be going on the Weaver. EE's going to have a very hard time dying twice now. I can see him dying once, but two times is almost impossible.
This is just a lot harder than I thought. Like, I know PR, as far as the brand goes, was always labeled as the team that would topple the favorites.
That was back in the old day with the old squad, though.
Yeah, that was a long time ago. That was back when FNG was still playing for him.
Yeah, and... Oh, man. Who was on that Power
Rangers? Can you remember the rest of them?
Damn, that is... That's like 2 years ago, I feel.
That's your ultimate trivia.
And Power Rangers has gone through a lot of changes.
I remember the next KZ lineup with Stalcat and Mantis and... That was the other one which always caused a couple of hiccups in tournaments. Goddamn. Okay, he is in a little bit of trouble, but not too much. Able to outrun the Scarabs. Always dangerous when your Silver Edge is on cooldown. But Arise is going to feel a lot more comfortable soon. That BKB needs to be completed for him. They need to make it so the Ravage of Bulba has to be delayed.
You also need to get a BKB on Slark too, and Queen of Pain.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can't go into these team fights and rely on Dark Tech to dodge ET all the time in Timbersaw damage.
Is that going to be enough though? Like, do you want to almost have like more stats to control?
I think it's better just for them to be able to freely run into the team fights. Like, honestly, I think you have to have Slark to have BKB. LC's just going to get blown up, I feel, by...
Can you double check the stream?
I see ya.
If
it's gone out, or if...
Yeah, I'm worried it's going to go out because it looks like it just reset.
Will we know in 5 minutes?
It's because of the net drop. Top tower is under attack. So, yeah, you know now. You know now because we're doing delay local. So hopefully it's going to be okay and it will survive through it all. I'm just seeing some very weird things coming up on my side. So.
Lag, it's other stuff. Looks like Secret want to go high ground here. At least force them back to the base.
Well, you do have Ravage, so you're feeling confident enough with the Blink Dagger on the Tidehunter. The Shadow Wave, however, might be causing a couple of problems. The kick is nice and arteezy. The armor, they're just trying to remove as much of it as possible.
There's Cloth's Blink. I'm at BKB. So this will help them a lot in team fights. For Ryze, he can just go balls deep.
It may not be something too Secret aware of. We know they're not aware of this. Ryze comes in close, got himself a double damage rune. The kick is nice over on two. Eternal Envy being silenced up by that. But Ryze can't even get that perfect Orchid. He wants to do it on Arteezy because Arteezy doesn't have a way to break free of it. Apart from death.
It's just a hard situation for them to be on for Power Rangers. They have to... Like I talked about, you have to heavily commit for Elder Titan, but he has a pipe. And in this situation, you can't even go onto Timbersaw because he has Shiva's Guard. He's super
Ooh,
tanky
God
right
damn.
Now.
He's there with a gem. The smoke instantly breaks. He's focusing on the Witch Doctor. Once Pilot Eye down, Eternal Limb, you're going to break the Aegis the Immortal. There goes your Ravage. It catches out one, but now in comes Arise. The BKB turned on. Goddamn gets back up the hill. Move away from the Splitter as he'll survive inside the Shadow Dance. And so will Arise on 120 HP. They'll live through this. Fortification buying some time, there's no creep wave, and Secret have committed big abilities for absolutely nothing. Goddamn wants to go in again, still with this gem. He knows that he is not visible. He's only stolen 5 essence, but having Bulba run up like this, he'll break with the Silver Edge. Bulba starts his TP out. So Secret, they must bail, and PR, they're on the hunt. They smell blood in the water, but they don't find an initiation. There's no kick coming in from Big Num. They will allow Team Secret to bail out.
Such a great play coming in from Power Rangers, and if that was a level 2 Maledict, that would have been a Slark dead. Oh my goodness, that is so unfortunate for Pilot Die.
It's so unfortunate for predictions as well. That was the perfect time. That was when Secret were meant to be taking a Rax.
Yeah, they needed to pressure. That was like when, yeah, you either take Rax or you force like 2 or 3 buybacks if there's even up for the side of Power Rangers, so that was a good timing window for them.
Can you double check again, just so I can feel comfortable? I'm just a little concerned, that's all. Okay, it's still alive. Just leave it up on the side. You don't even have to turn it off. Like, you're okay leaving that on your screen. So we just tab in and out if things go wrong.
Thought they wanted it off, though.
Only on this computer.
Oh, so I'm the skate. Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're the one that gets to keep alt tabbing and
cool.
Double checking and making sure everything is okay.
I can just talk to chat. Hey, chat, what's up, guys?
Yes, but they're 5 minutes late.
Oh, that sucks.
we have a delay to make this a competitive environment.
I'll just wait.
Well, there goes the tier 2 tower on the top, and that removes the last outer tower of Power Rangers. As this net worth is definitely rising back up, we get about 7.5k. The experience is a lot closer, but that's just because these team fights have been quite even on the trades. Even the farming start, like, the amount of farm taken up by both these sides being quite even. When Secret group up, PR making the most out of the side lanes. God damn, does he... Okay, he's got help. He's got help. The Blink, the Roar, the Necros, they're going to burn mana, and they're going to burn it quick. Arteezy, he is going to go down. The Suns remain. The suicide doesn't happen. And with Arteezy down, PR again by themselves some breathing room.
If could have got the suicide off, that would have been great. And that, you just, it's one Silver Edge just ruined your game for Nembersaw.
Goddamn's coming again. There's an Observer Ward down, but he's looking for a hero. Look at it, straight to Pylai's eye. He's still got so much essence that's been shifted over to him that he was hitting a lot harder. Finishes up the Ancients.
Man, this is looking so good for PR right now because we talked about it. They have the two BKBs online on their course. They can go as aggressive as they want. Can even find Eternal Envy here.
Yep.
He can latch on.
Yeah, with that gem, Envy just can't run away from BKB. This. Goddamn keeps going. Forces the BKB, and
so
that was
good.
The 10-second BKB charge of EE. With the creep wave arriving on the top lane, they can take the tier 2 tower. EE will not want to fight that.
Power Rangers just doing really well for themselves in this mid-game. They're doing all the right plays. And now that they have the Beastmaster with the Force Staff, this is a huge pickup, by the way. It might not look it, but it really is in these situations where you can cancel the Lincoln Sphere on Weaver with the Force Staff. That's what he wants to do. So Eternal Envy, he's not going to feel as safe as he once did around the map, because all it's going to take is Beastmaster plus one, and Envy is going to die now because they have ways to trigger that Lincoln Sphere now.
At the same time, like, okay, so we're talking about ways where EE could die.
Well, he's going to have to eventually split push the map up. And
yeah. This game's going to go for so long, though.
Yeah, that's the
so
thing.
Long, because
if it's long games, then there's going to be so many pickoffs around the map, like solo pickoffs. Like, Timber's going to be farming solo, EE's going to be farming solo.
It's like, it's the only way, though, you're going to be able to win this is going so late. The PR just has so much strength. Ravage, Arise, they are going to commit. He started the blink animation, but he wasn't going to get away. So you burn your Ravage. But like, Secret Defending, you got Naginim's Timbersaw as well as just the Spirit from Elder Titan. Just that enough is enough to keep PR out. They need to find pickoffs across the map. For Secret to get a pickoff, they need to commit something as big as a Ravage in order to make it work as well. Because you don't have a Weaver who is like a lockdown number one position that you get with like Basher style heroes.
Abyssal Blade, Timber coming.
Yeah, you know, we mock that a little bit, but still. It shouldn't happen. Get it on somebody else.
Yeah, there's even a Sheepstick. Honestly, I think RTZ will go Sheepstick eventually. But other than, like you talked about, the initiation is only a Ravage.
Ooh, Cheshire, so close. He knows he's so close. And so does Slark.
Disco.
As we will lag once again.
Doing the fish dance. Doot, 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 doot.
Always makes me concerned.
Man, I didn't drop. Still alive.
Beautiful. So Cheshire Cat, Envy staying so close. They need to find an opening. The Observer Ward, goddamn, as she starts to D-ward. He doesn't have a way down. He's on the hillside. It's almost like that.
No
just, stuns, that looks like such good bait, though.
Yeah, because you have low cooldown spells with Slark with the Pounce and Dark Pack. Worst case scenario, you just pop BKB, but they don't have stuns, as we talked about. It's like, what the hell did they even do?
PR? He's going to steal the haste through time lapses. He was not taking any chances there.
Do they have Ravage? 50 seconds.
No.
Oh, man.
They have Spirit and Swarm, though. This may be enough to dissuade Power Rangers. Because it's still going to take PR a while. Like, Roshan's ticking down. Now, over they come again. Another Spirit in for Puppy. Gonna get that stomp off, BKB from Eternal Envy, looking for some kind of kill, looking in the pit, but nope, he keeps fighting up against Big Gun, the man who was running around Infant. Now RTZ on his way in, Bobble will go for the jump, gets bashed by Roshan, the Sonic Wave, Envy, time lapse, it was 2 seconds of cooldown, now he's right back, time lapse has entered the pit, so he's straight back onto the front line, Horizon inside the pit, is killed by the dive, picked up by the Queen of Pain, and she instantly triggers it. The Aegis to the Immortal, J4's in the neighborhood, Shadow Wave over on three of the heroes of Team Secret, but it's not stopping RTZ. Up to the front lines, Bulba, Ravage is off cooldown now. Blink, however, is on cooldown. They're gonna bait him in, they wanna try and fight this, the Ravage hits everybody! Arise, you can chain it up, but it gets sliced in two! I was saying it's a bread knife, but it's actually a rotating sawmill in the hands of RTZ. J4 can't even TP out now, he is gonna go down! And the movement is coming into the base. Through the bottom lane, we have enough time for me to actually get the prediction before 40 minutes. They need to take the racks. And they're looking towards the mid. It's the most exposed. Queen of Pain will have to buy back here for Eternal Envy. There she is. Thank you very much, EE. He's now given me two correct predictions. Big Num goes for the kick, but... And EE's still got his BKB. They'll take the melee racks. And Power Rangers, goddamn. Getting up in the face of RTZ. Enough for Secret to be a little bit wary. Remember, they do not have the Ravage, but they want to finish this melee racks at least with this trip in. Because they haven't got the buyback. Now EE, Blink, Raw. That Grease actually giving more mana to fight with. And the Storm from Puppy. Perfect. The Death Ward from Pylai die as well. Down on the ground. Goddamn. Running back past his tier 4 towers. Arise will come back to life, but there is a hole in his home.
Fighting into Mech and Pipe at this stage in the game with only three heroes, that is devastating for the side of Power Rangers. They should have just waited, gave up that Rax. They need their heavy hitters. They need the Queen of Pain, Sonic Wave. And them going back into that bottom team fight, back to Ravage, that's going to cost Power Rangers this game, potentially.
Mm-hmm.
So now they're on the back foot. Were any buybacks committed is the question. So Slark had a buyback. EE, as we talked about, he bought back. Time lapse, great play into the Roche pit.
Yep. If they didn't have his damage, then that would have been like, it would have been PR's fight completely.
Yep.
But he also can be feeling really, really pissed about it because he wasn't stunned up when he was dying. It was literally 2 seconds, maybe 1 second and a half. For that time lapse to come off cooldown, so he wouldn't have even
that,
had
that
to come...
That cheeky haste rune still. Caught in him.
Yeah, he wouldn't have had to use the buyback if that happened.
But what looked like a really good game for Power Rangers has just turned bad because Slark has been holding on to what seems like 4.5k gold for the last, I want to say, 7-8 minutes. Like, got him. He's like so lost right now as to decide what his next item is. If they could have had that for that Roche, they could have potentially finished it off in time. So they, he's.
I'm wondering what he does buy.
It's...
Yeah.
You need like the problem is you need Abyssal Blade and you also need a heavy DPS item right now. Like, I'm not even joking. Like,
I'm wondering if he actually tries to find like.
It's not even that bad this game, but.
I was thinking about that. I'm actually wondering if he goes for the more expensive item in Bloodthorn. Because you still need to have the extra silence and some damage. Like, in a way that kind of ticks both boxes. I'm thinking a little bit outside the box. It's not something which Goddamn would probably be looking towards. I'm just thinking it's something where he could at least assault into Arteezy. Especially when Arteezy is buying up a Scythe of Ice.
Oh, he's got
but he may need a Monkey King, but the Solar Crest is now done over on ET.
Yeah, might need that.
Sells the could Midas. As 5.9k.
Rapier.
That would be ballsy.
I'm actually thinking...
No, it's a Monkey King bar. It's a Monkey King bar.
That's
I think
just a standard.
I don't know if he actually saw the Solar Crest, but it comes at the right time to have it. The only downside is, obviously, he doesn't have buyback because he already spent his money beforehand. Beastmaster is the only one from PR that currently has his buyback.
This double Ravage is going to be insane, though, from Bulba. Like, he could whiff the first one on purpose and just bait him in.
Wait for it. Wrap around from behind. Goddamn is there. The Observer Ward, however, is seeing him. So he knows he has to bail out. He also knows it because he's losing his bonus.
Yep, there's a Sheep Stick, as we talked about from RTZ, if you said it earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's their initiation.
Oh, goddamn, wait. He needs someone to come in close. EE's gonna be it. The silence is there. The pounce. The BKB and time lapse. Ravage will blow. Cheshire Cat's in trouble. The ET splitter with the stomp and the paralyzing card's gonna the second one from Bulba. Hits the mark perfectly. And that is gonna be a triple kill for Eternal Envy and GG. Well played. Team Secret will take their first game here in the group stage up against PR, but it was not an easy thing. An ultra kill for Envy at the end. Well, I gotta be wrong about the number of deaths at the end too. It was 33, man. 33, a little bit off. But I at least got 2 out of 4.
I got 0 for 4.
Also,
I don't know why
shout out
this.
To the stream who just tuned into us. You came in at the worst possible time
because
you missed all of the fun, which we are having on the number 4 stream. We're going to have more fun as well, Ryu. We're going to be back here in a little bit as I double check our...